released and no more migrant children were being held at the temporary tent shelter at the Tornillo port of entry as of Friday morning, according to the Department of Health and Human Services. All the children who were being held at the shelter have been released to sponsors or transferred to other shelters, said Lynn Johnson, Assistant Secretary of the Administration for Children and Families. Operations at Tornillo will be ongoing to appropriately and adequately continue the path towards closure, Johnson said in a statement. Federal officials have been working since early this month to close the shelter as quickly but as safely as possible. There were still 850 children at the shelter as of Monday night. Republican U.S. Representative Will Hurd, whose district includes parts of Far East El Paso County, first announced the shelter's impending closure after speaking with management officials in Tornillo. This tent city should never have stood in the first place, but it is welcome news that it will be gone, Hurd wrote on Twitter. Opponents of the facility celebrated news of its closure Friday. Beto O'Rourke, El Paso's former Democratic congressman, applauded those who joined his protest in Tornillo last year against the facility and family separations. The last child has left Tornillo, O'Rourke wrote on Twitter. It's good for these kids and their families. And it shows the power of people who showed up for them and shared with the rest of the country that we were locking up immigrant kids for months at a time. You made this happen. State Senator Jose Rodriguez, D. El Paso, said in an emailed statement, I am pleased to hear that the last child has been released from detention in the Tornillo tent city. It is important to emphasize that the facility never should have existed. No child belongs in detention. He added, furthermore, no family belongs in detention. I understand that CBP may have intended to use the tent facilities for family detentions. That would not be welcomed by this community, and we will do everything we can to oppose that, should it occur. Fernando Garcia, executive director of the Border Network for Human Rights, celebrated news of the closure of what he called the baby jail and said officials should learn from the facility and look for alternatives to detention in the future. Tornillo was a symbol of this administration's deep inhumanity as shown by their willingness to hold tens of thousands of migrant children in detention, he said in a statement. Migrant children and families never should have been separated or held in detention. This was clear from Tornillo's opening to its closure today. Garcia also credited those who protested the facility with its closure. Ordinary Americans mobilized repeatedly to denounce Tornillo and denounce child detention, he said. The closure of Tornillo is a win for the community, and for our values, in the face of a callous, racist, and inhumane government. Our resistance can change lives. The facility at Tornillo opened in June to help the federal government handle an influx of children entering federal custody after being separated from their parents at the border under the Trump administration's zero-tolerance immigration policy. It started as an operation large enough to hold more than 300 children, but grew quickly in size and was housing as many as 2,700 children in the middle of December. Those children were not among those separated from their parents, but minors who were apprehended attempting to cross the border without a guardian. The facility had stayed operational because the federal government was slow to place children with sponsors in the United States. Authorities pointed to a delay in FBI background checks as the primary roadblock. The Department of Health and Human Services changed its policy in December to expedite the release of children, requiring background checks for sponsors, but not from all members of a sponsor's household. Johnson said facilities like Tornillo are necessary for HHS to care for children referred to us by the Department of Homeland Security. As the Trump administration continues to enforce current laws to address our nation's crisis at the border, the program will need to continue to evaluate needs and capacity in order to care for the hundreds of children that cross the U.S. border daily, she said. While many local leaders who oppose the facility celebrated Friday's news, State Representative Mary Gonzalez, D. Clint, said advocates should stay focused on the work that remains. Though the Tornillo shelter is now closed, The fight for meaningful and humane immigration reform continues, she said. Many children across the country remain detained and separated from their parents and loved ones, and our federal government continues to expend time and energy on a contrived crisis relating to a wall along the border, rather than the real crisis at hand, the families and children suffering from the trauma of separation, and asylum seekers who are being unjustly denied entry to this country. Madeline Meckelberg is a reporter with the USA Today Network Austin Bureau. She may be reached at 512-479-6606. Meckelberg at elpasotimes.com. At Madeline Mick on Twitter. Subscribe now.